Ever since I was young, growing up on a farm in northwest Iowa, I've always been fascinated with the potential in a seed, that one seed could produce so much. And if you look at that sheaf of wheat, you'll see that there's over 40 kernels of wheat in just that one plant, that one sheaf. And so when I began writing Boundless Compassion, I thought about the seeds of compassion in us, that every single one of us is born with the potential for compassion. And we need to tend and nurture those seeds. And so the four seeds that I think are most essential for compassion are non-judgment, non-violence, forgiveness, and awareness or mindfulness. And so we do not want to increase suffering, and therefore we want to be non-judgmental. We want to have respect for our differences and also look beneath those where we're more alike than different and see that we all want happiness, we want peace and meaning for our lives, and we want well-being. And so with nonviolence, you know, we want to be aware of what are in our thoughts and in our feelings. We do not want hostile thoughts. We need to watch our words and, of course, our gestures, whether it's a finger or our harsh glances and glares that we might give at someone. And with forgiveness, we want to be able to have an open heart, a soft heart, not hold grudges. We'll have memories of hurt, but we want to set those aside and be able to be open to be a person of love and kindness. And of course, that last one, awareness or mindfulness, that means that we're going to take time every day to have some quiet time so we know what's going on in our mind and our heart. So we're not going to send out anything except something that's kind and loving and gracious. And so I'm going to close this with a quote from Thich Nhat Hanh, where he really emphasizes our being aware. And this is what he writes. We have seeds of compassion, understanding, and love in us. We all have many good seeds of happiness and joy, yet we also have the habit of running in us. This restless energy of dissatisfaction and struggle separates us from the present moment and from ourselves. And so we want to be in touch with ourselves when we're compassionate. And so I encourage you to tend the garden of your heart and to grow stronger in being a compassionate presence.